আসসালামু আলাইকুম, আই এম ডক্টর খাদিজা, অ্যাসোসিয়েট প্রফেসর ডিপার্টমেন্ট অফ ফিজিওলজি ফ্রম বসুন্ধরা আর্দান মেডিকেল কলেজ। সো ওয়েলকাম ইউ টু দিস অনলাইন ক্লাস। টুডে আই এম গোয়িং টু ডিসকাস অ্যান ইম্পর্টেন্ট টপিক অফ এন্ডোক্রাইনোলজি, দ্যাট ইজ থাইরয়েড ফিজিওলজি। হিয়ার উইল ডিসকাস দ্য বায়োসিনথেসিস, ট্রান্সপোর্ট ফাংশন, রেগুলেশন অফ সিক্রেশন অ্যান্ড দ্য ডিসঅর্ডার্স অফ থাইরয়েড অ্যাবনর্মালিটি, দ্যাট ইজ হাইপোথাইরয়েডিজম, হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজম, cretinism, myxedema, and goiters. First, I am going to discuss the thyroid anatomy and the anatomic location. Thyroid gland is one of the largest gland, endocrine gland, that is located immediately below the larynx on either side of the, just below the larynx on either side of the trachea. It is weighs is about 15 to 20 gram in adult. It is located in the cervical ring C5 to thoracic 1, immediately below the larynx and anterior to the trachea. Thyroid gland has two lobes. It extends from the level of thyroid cartilage to the 5th to 6th tracheal ring, and they are connected with each other by isthmus at the level of 2nd to 3rd tracheal ring. The gland is extremely vascular organ with an extensive blood supply and lymphatic capillary network. The thyroid gland has a more blood supply, it is about 5 times more than its weight in each minute. So it shows the vascularity of the thyroid gland. The figure we can see it aggregates its blood supply from superior inferior thyroid artery. The thyroid gland is not essential for life, but it is important for the following facts. That is, it is important for regulation of gene expression, regulation of growth and development, and regulation of general metabolism, and regulation of tissue differentiation. Though it is not essential for life, but its absence or hypofunctioning during fetal life and neonatal life results in severe mental retardation. Now we will discuss the physiological anatomy of thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is composed of a large number of follicles. There are the secretory substance called colloid, lined with the cuboidal epithelial cells that secretes into the interior of the cell of the follicles. The major constituent of the colloid particle is the thyroglobulin, that is a globular protein that contains the thyroid hormone. In the figure, you can see the follicles with the surrounded by the cuboidal cells. There is about 20 to 40 eventual dispersed follicles are seen in each thyroid gland. In this figure, you can see the active stage and inactive stage of thyroid gland. Inactive state is the cell become columnar in active stage, but in inactive stage the cell are lined with cuboidal cells. Now the cell types we found in the thyroid gland, there are two types of cells. There are follicular cells and parafollicular cells. Follicular cells are principal cells, and that two major hormones are synthesized from the follicular cells, that is tetraiodothyronine or T4, that is about 90%, and triiodothyronine or T3, that is 7%, derived from the modification of tyrosine. Parafollicular cells, that is C cells, it synthesizes calcitonin or thyrocalcitonin. In this figure, you can see the tyrosine molecule. It is the which is iodinated and subsequently form T3 and T4. You can see that tyrosine is iodinated to form T4 and also T3. Difference between T3 and T4. The thyroid secretes about 80 micrograms of T4, but about 4 micrograms of T3 per day. However, T4 has much biological activity than T4, that is about 4 times more than the T4. In addition, 25 microgram per day T3 is produced in peripherally by deiodination of T4. Now, what is the raw material for synthesis of T4? That is iodine. Iodine is the raw material for synthesis of thyroid hormone. The essential factors, other essential factors are amino acid, tyrosine, and enzyme thyroid peroxidase, accompanying with hydrogen peroxide. Why iodine is important in thyroid hormone production? That is, iodine is an essential raw material for formation of thyroxine, because the thyroid hormone are unique biological molecule that they incorporate in their structure, iodine in their structure. Thus, adequate iodine intake with a diet and water is required for the normal thyroid hormone production. Now, what are the sources of thyroid iodine? Iodine can be, we can get iodine from exogenous source or endogenous source. If for exogenous source, we can get iodine by iodinated salt or iodinated bread or milk and dairy product or sea fish. Our endogenous source from a thyroid gland and for by metabolism of T3-T4 in peripheral tissues. Minimum requirement for the thyroid hormone production iodine is about 75 microgram per day. So iodine intake in adult 150 microgram per day or 1 milligram per week or 50 milligram per year. But UK it is more, that is 200 to 500 micrograms per day. Now the regulation of thyroid hormone synthesis. Thyroid hormone regulation is mainly negatively regulated. A negative feedback mechanism, that is first thyroid releasing hormone synthesis from the hypothalamus, and it stimulates anterior pituitary to secrete thyroid stimulating hormone. This thyroid stimulating hormone act on thyroid gland to produce thyroid hormone, that is TTT4. When TTT4 level increases in blood, it sends negative feedback to the anterior pituitary gland and as well as to the hypothalamus. As a result, decreases the releasing hormone and thyroid stimulating hormone, and decreases the thyroid hormone production. Thyroid stimulating hormone is actually a protein hormone. It has it act on the receptor of the thyroid gland follicles and act by production of secondary messengers like cyclic AMP, IP3 and diacyl glycerol. Now, the transport of T3 and T4. In plasma, T3-T4 is mainly transported through the blood by inbound from with the thyroid binding globulin, but in less amount with the thyroid binding prealbumin and albumin. Only free hormones are available for tissue actions. Plasma level of T4 in adult is about 8 microgram per dL, and plasma level of T3 in adult is about 0.15 microgram per deciliter. Metabolism of thyroid hormone. Series of deiodination or by deiodinase enzyme in liver, kidney, thyroid, pituitary gland, brain, brown fat, and placenta and pituitary gland. So other that convert T4 to T3, and other metabolic pathways are sulfation, decarboxylation conjugated with glucuronides. Now, action of thyroid stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone act, it causes increased uptake of iodine. It stimulates other reactions involved in thyroid hormone synthesis. It stimulates the uptake of colloids. It also induces growth of the thyroid gland. Now, what is thyroglobulin? Thyroglobulin is actually a globular protein that is produced in the endoplasmic reticulum of the follicular cells, and then secreted into the as a colloid particle into the follicle. It is about it has two subunits. It contain 123 tyrosine residues. Thyroid hormones are synthesized on in the colloid by iodination and condensation by tyrosine molecules bound in peptide linkage in thyroglobulin. Now we are going to discuss the synthesis, biosynthesis of thyroid hormone. There are about 5 steps in synthesis of thyroid hormone synthesis. First step is iodide trapping or iodide pump, then oxidation of iodide pump, then organification of thyroglobulin, that iodination of tyrosine and formation of thyroid hormone, then coupling of iodinase residues and release of T3-T4 in the blood. And this figure shows the biosynthesis, different steps of biosynthesis. You should memorize this figure so you can discuss. Now, this is the first step is iodide trapping. Iodide is actively transported from the blood into the follicular cell at the basolateral membrane by the symporter, that is the name of the symporter, sodium iodide symporter. Sodium iodide is a co-transporter. By this it is active transporter. By this iodide is actively transported into the cell, then it is transported out from the follicular cell to the apical membrane by a transporter called colloid chloride iodide counter transport or pendrine. Then the second step is oxidation of iodide ion, that is conversion of iodide into oxidized form of iodine by peroxidase enzyme with the presence of hydrogen peroxide. Then oxidized ion has the capacity to combine directly with the amino acid tyrosine. Now, organification of thyroglobulin. What is organification? It is the binding of iodine with the thyroglobulin molecule called organification of thyroglobulin molecule. Thyroglobulin molecule released from the Golgi apparatus and secreted into the apical cell to the into the follicle. Tyrosine is first iodinized to monoiodotyrosine and then diiodotyrosine by the enzyme iodinase. Now we'll discuss the oxidative coupling. Oxidative coupling means more and more iodotyrosine residues become coupled with one another. That is, two DIT, the diiodotyrosine molecules undergo a oxidative condensation from T4, and then T3 is formed with the condensation of MIT, that is monoiodotyrosine, and DIT, that is diiodotyrosine. A small amount of reverse T3 is formed by condensation of DIT with MIT. So, after formation of the thyroid hormone, it can be stored in the follicles about 2 to 3 months. Then the step release of the thyroid hormone from the thyroid gland. Thyroglobulin itself not released into the circulation, but T3 and T4 is clipped from the thyroglobulin molecule and then released into the circulation. First, the apical membrane surrounds the produces C-depot and formation of pinocytic vesicle that containing the thyroglobulin molecule at enters into the follicular cells. When it enters into the follicular cells, they bind with the lysosomal enzymes, digestive enzyme that degrade the protein molecule and clip the T3-T4 from the tyrosine, thyroglobulin, and then this T3-T4 release into the circulation, but remaining the MIT and DIT that is not released into circulation, they become deiodinases by the enzyme, and the iodinase reuse for synthesis of new T3-T4, and the tyrosine is also reused for formation of new T3-T4. Now, the secretion. Thyroid gland secret more T3 than T4, that is 93% T4 and only 7% T3. We have already discussed this, that T3 is more active than T4, and half-life of T4 is 6 days, but T3 is 1 day. Mechanism of thyroid hormone action. Now, I will discuss the mechanism of thyroid action. We know that thyroid hormone has the receptors in the nucleus. So, thyroid hormone is a protein-soluble hormone. It can easily diffuse through the cellular membrane into the cytoplasm, then enters into the nucleus, through the nuclear membrane, and bind with the receptors present in the DNA specific site, and formation of the hormone receptor complex, and then it causes transcription. Genetic transcription and formation of the messenger RNA. This messenger RNA enters into cytoplasm and then formed formation of new protein by translation, and this new protein causes exerts cellular effects. We can see in this figure there are different types of cellular effects. That is, after formation of new protein, that is, it may act in different systems. It has effect on growth. It has effect on central nervous system, also cardiovascular system and metabolism. That's all of my topics today. Thanks for your patience hearing. So thank you, students, and I hope you will remain well and be safe. Allah Hafiz.